apply these concepts to compute probability given the distributional parameters. By parameters, I mean that when I say X is a uniform distribution between A and B are specified as the parameters of my distribution. So, suppose X is a standard uniform random variable over the interval 0, 1. So, X is uniform 0, 1. My A is 0, B is 1. What is probability? So, these are what I want to find out. Probability X is greater than 1 by 3. We know that probability X is greater than X is going to be the same as probability X is less than or equal to X. Okay. That is because I know that the probability is going to be both probability X greater or equal to X plus probability X is less than or equal to X is equal to 1. So, this is 1 minus your probability X is less than or equal to 1 by 3, and I know that for a standard uniform distribution, F of X is equal to X. This is what we saw, okay? And hence, I have probability X is less than or equal to 1 by 3, which is equal to F of 1 by 3, which is equal to 1 by 3, which will give me probability X is greater than 1 by 3 is 1 minus 1 by 3, which is 2 by 3. So, I have X is greater than 1 by 3 is 2 by 3. Probability X is less than or equal to 0.7 is trivial. Probability X is less than or equal to X is equal to X. Here my small x is 0.7. So, probability X is less than or equal to 0.7 is 0.7. Now, given any 2 points, probability of say C is less than or equal to X is less than or equal to D, I know is the same as probability X is less than or equal to D minus probability X is less than or equal to C. Now, why is this true? So, let us look at the understanding we have. I have this is my density function, which is defined between C and D is what I want to know. So, this I have A to B. So, A to B is going to be my entire probability, and I know integral A to B f of x dx is equal to 1. So, given any density function. Now, if I am interested in knowing probability C is less than X is less than or equal to D, what I am effectively asking is this blue area. That is what I want to know. Now, if I want to know the blue area, okay, that blue area is the same as I can find out what is this entire area, the orange area minus the purple area. Right? The blue area would be the orange area minus the purple area. The orange area is nothing but, the orange area is nothing but probability of X is less than or equal to D. That is my orange area. If I look at the orange area is going to be, the orange area is going to be, this orange shaded region is probability X is less than or equal to D, because this is my D. The entire orange shaded region is probability X is less than or equal to D. The purple shaded region, the only the purple shaded region is going to be probability of X is less than or equal to C, and the difference in these two areas is what I originally had as my blue shaded region, and that is what we wanted. The blue shaded region is what we wanted, was the area enclosed between C and D. So, if I am interested in knowing for any two constants C and D, the probability C is less than or equal to X is less than or equal to D, I find out probability X is less than or equal to D minus probability X is less than or equal to C. Now, my D here is 0.9. So, this would be a F 0.9 minus 0.3, which I am going to get as a 0.6. So, similarly, if I am looking at 0.2 is less than or equal to 0.0. So, what I want to tell here is probability C is less than X is less than D is the same as C is less than or equal to X is less than D, which is same as C is less than X is less than or equal to D. Again, because X is a continuous random variable, these probabilities are the same, because in a uniform distribution, this is how I have defined it. So, what is probability 0.2 is less than or equal to X is less than 0.8? Again, F of 0.8 minus F of 0.2, which I again get is 0.6, and that is displayed on the screen. So, given, so this was when X is a uniform between 0 and 1. I can do the same exercise if it was a uniform between minus 1 and 1. What would happen? Suppose I have a X which is uniformly distributed between minus 1 and 1. My F of X again is 1 by 2. Okay. And I can verify that minus 1 to 1. F of X dx is going to be 1 by 2 into 2, which is equal to 1. So, in which case probability X is greater than 1 by 3 is going to be 1 minus F of 2 by 3. Now, what is your F of X here? Your F of X is going to be your X plus 1 by 2. That is what your F of X is going to be. So, F of 1 by 3 is going to be your 1 by 3 plus 1 divided by 2, okay. That is what is your 4 by 6, which is my 2 by 3, and 1 minus 2 by 3 is 1 by 3. So, that is how I get f of x is greater than 1 by 3. For the other problems, I just leave it as an exercise for you all to verify what are the problems when X is equal to a uniform minus 1 to 1. Now, let us look at an application of a uniform distribution. Suppose I am asked to meet a friend at 2 p.m. I am always on time, but my friend is always late, and he can arrive at a meeting place any time, and the chance that he will arrive at any time between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m. is the same. In other words, if X is the amount of time I am going to wait for my friend, if he arrives at 2 p.m. because I have arrived at 2 p.m., I do not wait. If he arrives at 2:10, I will have to wait for 10 minutes. If he arrives at 2:20, I wait for 20 minutes. If he arrives at 2:30, I would have to wait for 30 minutes, and 2:40, 2:50, and if he arrives at 3, I wait for 60 minutes. So, if X is the amount of time I am going to wait, I know time is being measured, the amount of time I am going to wait is uniformly distributed, whether I am waiting for 10 minutes or 20 minutes or 30 minutes, it is uniformly distributed in the interval 2 to 3. So, what is the first thing? So, I either wait the time I am going to, so the total time I wait, the minimum is 0, the maximum is 60. I do not wait for anything when he comes at 2. I wait for 60 minutes when he comes at 30. And that, so I can look at the time of waiting to be a uniformly distributed random variable between 0 minutes and 60 minutes. Now, this is the key thing to identify in modeling problems. So, I am saying that this and this x belong, x is distributed 0 to 60 comes from this information. That is, this person will arrive at a time that is uniformly distributed between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m. Hence, my waiting time, the time I wait is either 0 minutes or the maximum time I wait is 60 minutes. Hence, the time I wait is going to be uniformly distributed between 0 minutes and 60 minutes. Why is it a continuous random variable? Because I am measuring time. And you also recall that whenever I am measuring and not counting, I will discuss or I will refer to it as a continuous random variable. So, the question now, first I have understood that x is a uniform between 0 and 60. So, let's translate these questions first in terms of x. So, the first thing is x is my waiting time. It is at least 30 minutes, I have to find out probability x is greater or equal to 30. Less than 15 minutes, probability x is less than 15. Between 10 and 15 minutes is going to be x lies between 10 and 50. And less than 45 is going to be x is less than 45. I again recall less than 45 and less than or equal to 45 does not make a difference when you are referring to continuous random variables. So, let us look at one by one. Probability x is greater or equal to 30. X is greater or equal to 30. Again, x is a uniform 0 to 60. I know probability x is greater or equal to 30 is the same as 1 minus probability x is less than or equal to 30. And for x, which is a uniform 0 to 60, f of x is going to be x minus 0 by 60, which is x by 60 for x lies between 0 and 60. Now, 30 lies between 0 and 60. So, 1 minus f of 30 is going to 1 by f of 30 is going to be 30 by 60, which is going to be equal to half. So, the chance that a person waits for at least 30 minutes is 1 by 2, which seems reasonable. Suppose I know a person is going to come any time between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m. and the chance that he arrives at any point of time in this interval is going to is the same, then the wait that you are going to wait for at least 30 minutes is going to be that he arrives between 2:30 to 3. I know he is going to definitely arrive between 2 and 3. So, the chance he is going to arrive in this interval is a 50% chance and that is given by half. Less than 15 minutes. Again, let us look at it. So, now again, what would be less than 15 minutes? Greater than 30 minutes. So, this is 0 minute, this is 30 minutes, this is 60 minutes, this is going to be 15 minutes, this is going to be 45 minutes. So, again, one way is greater than 30, we know was half. So, less than 15 is going to be this. So, what do you think would be this? You can see that greater than 30 is half. This is 1/4 of this total area. So, you can also verify that probability x is less than or equal to 15 is f of 15. Again, recall f of x is x by 60, which is going to be 15 by 60, which is 1 by 4. Again, if the area of this entire rectangle is 1, I know this area, the shaded blue region is going to be 1 by 4. Or there is a 25% chance that you will wait for less than 15 minutes. Now, let us look at between 10 and 35 minutes. Again, let's go back. I have a 0 minute here. I'm just shifting this one, and this is 60 minutes. So this is 30 minutes, this is 15 minutes. So this is going to be your 10th minute is here and your 35th minute is here. So another way to look at it is, let's look at 0 minute here, 60 minutes here, 30. So this is 10, 20, 40, 50. Okay. And I am interested in knowing, I know it is the same probability across. So between 10 minute and 35 minutes. Now between 15 and 0, I knew it was 1 by 4. So this is also going to be 1 by 4. So this is the area we are seeking now. Okay. So this is f of 35 minus f of 10, which is 35 minus 10 by 60, which I get is 25 by 60, which is a 5 by 12 probability. Okay. So the last thing is less than 45 minutes, probability x is less than or equal to 45. This is straightforward, which is going to be 45 by 60, and I know that is 3/4, and that you can see that if this is a 0 and this is a 60 and this is a 30, this is a 45, this is a 15, I know the area which is going to be less than or equal to this is 3/4 of the total area. The total area was 1. So hence this is 3/4. And the chance that you will be waiting for less than 45 minutes is a pretty high 75% chance. So what we have seen so far is, we looked at what was a uniform random variable, what is a standard uniform distribution, and we looked at a simple application of a uniform distribution. The key point to note is, when you are looking at a uniform distribution and an application, first recognize what are your parameters. So we recognize what is the variable, define the variable. So in our application, we define the variable to be the amount of time you wait. And since it was given to be that you're waiting equally between this time interval 2 p.m. to 3 p.m., we recognized A as 0 and B as 60. And then once we find out and establish this, it is easy for us to answer questions regarding this, whatever questions we need to know. We are translating it in terms of probabilities.